Any type of fault can be analyzed by using this ZBus. This is one of the example for analysis of fault analysis by using bus impedance matrix. Next we'll see 12th question. For a power system network with n nodes, Z33 of its bus impedance matrix is J0.5 per unit. So for n bus system, so Z33 is given by J0.5 per unit. The voltage at node 3 is V3 is given as 1.3 at an angle minus 10 degrees per unit. All values are given in per unit, right? So if a capacitor having a reactance of minus J3.5 per unit is now added to the network between the node 3 and reference. So a capacitance of C, capacitance of reactance means XC as given J3.5 per unit. Say it as this ZC, J3.5, minus J3.5 per unit is added. C, these are old ZBus network, it's an old power system network having n number of buses. So he has added a capacitance of reactance of having minus J0.3 at node 3. Say that this is node 3, has connected a capacitance having a reactance of ZC minus J3.5 per unit at this one. Now he is asking, what is the current drawn by the capacitor per unit? So what is the current drawn by this one? This IC. Is what node voltage V3 or not? So the capacitor current is given by this node through VC by, it is what? Z33. This Z33 means what? New. Why it is new? By adding an element of XC between node 3 and reference. It is not creating any node. It is what comes under type 3. Here I want to find out Z33 new. Z33 new is equal to ZBus old minus 1 by Z33 plus ZS into some matrices. Okay. So it is what? Here I want to find out Z33 new is equal to Z33 plus ZC. Directly you can say. So it is will be J0.5 plus of minus J3.5. So it will be minus J3 per unit. The value of Z33 new is minus J3 per unit. So find out the value of capacitor current. So current drawn by the capacitor is equal to current which is flows through from node 3. It will be I3 is equal to node voltage V3 by Z33 new. So node voltage V3 means 1.3 at an angle minus 10 degrees by minus J3 per unit. So here we got 0.433 at an angle plus 80 degrees per unit. So magnitude of this current drawn by this one is 0.433 is the answer. So if anyone asking the current drawn means, no, don't substitute the angle, but substitute only magnitude. So if he is asking the angle, separately you have to make it is 80. Okay. Next 14th question, I will give the hint for you. The bus admittance matrix is given for any positive network. The impedance of the line between bus 2 and 3 is equal to. So first we have to find out Y23. So admittance connected between 2 and 3 will be what? Minus J10. It is minus J10. Okay, the inverse of that value, admittance will give you this impedance. Z23 is equal to 1 by Y23, 1 by minus J10. We give you minus plus J0.1 is the answer. 14th one. Next 15th one, you can form the ZBus. Find the value of Z22. Easy way. Next 16th question. So he's asking, a 75 MVA 10 kV synchronous generator has, it is a direct axis reactance, means transient reactance of 0.4 per unit. So the value XD value in per unit to a base value of 100 MVA and 11 kV is. So for a generator having XD of J 0.5 per unit on base values of 75 MVA and 11 kV. So what is the value of this reactance on 100 MVA and 11 kV is? This is 10 kV. Okay. So if you want to find out nu value of reactance is equal to old value into old per unit value into MVA nu by is MVA base nu by MVA base old into KVB old square by KVB nu square. So this is old value of per unit value J0.4. Here I want to find out the per unit value of this XD reactance of generator on new base values of 100 MVA and 11 kV. These two are new base values. So it is what? 100 by old value should be 75 into KVB old means 10 by 11 whole square. Okay. So if you calculate this one, you are getting 0.44077 per unit. Means J0.441 is a accurate value. Next, 17th question. As we already solved 17th question, when we are discussing about stability analysis. So see, the per unit parameters of for a 500 MVA machine on its own base are as given inertia, per unit value of inertia, M is equal to what? 20 per unit, and reactance of generator or machine is given by X is equal to 2 per unit on base values of what? 500 MVA, its own base value. He is asking that is the per unit value of M. What is the per unit value of M and reactance per unit value on 100 MVA base? Suppose if I want to find out per unit value of M, since we already know inertia constant is inversely proportional to Z, then if I want to find out the per unit value of H, inertia constant, on this new value, you have to multiply with old value by denominator value. So it is M per unit nu is equal to M per unit old into, this is what inversely, right? So we have to write here MVA base old by MVA base nu. Okay. So here it per unit value is 20 into old base MVA is 500. So which will be 100 per unit. So value of this one will be, ratio of the generator machine will be 100 per unit. If you want to find out reactance, per unit value of reactance on new value is equal to new old value into this new MVA by old MVA, so which will be 0.4 per unit. 0.4 per unit. So this answer will be 100, 0.4. Next, 20th question. So, a single phase star connected load is drawing power at voltage of 0.9 per unit. A single phase load means it is drawing a single phase voltage of 0.9 per unit voltage. Okay. So under this load is having power factor of 0.8 lagging. 0.8 lagging power factor. So the three phase base power and base current are of 100 MVA and 437.38 respectively, amperes of current respectively, the line to line voltage in KVEs. So if I want to find out line to line voltage, means actual value, this is what actual value is equal to per unit value into means base value. Base value means for three phase system he has connected a single phase load, the voltage across single phase load he has given 0.9 per unit. If I want actual value means line to line voltage value, then we have to substitute, multiply this one with base voltage. So as we know, has given base voltage of base MVA of how much? Base MVA of 100 and base current of 437.38 amperes. Okay. Now from by using these to find out the value of base voltage. So it is what? Three phase base MVA, right? So here we need to find out base voltage. Base voltage is of line to line voltage equal to base MVA of three phase by root 3 into base current. Okay. So it will be 100 into 10 power 6 of base MVA root 3 into 437.38. So it is base voltage, we are getting it as 132 kV. So if I want to find out line to line voltage across load is equal to per unit value into base value, 132 kV. So here this value are getting 118 kV. Is asking the line to line voltage across the load in kilo V. KV means it is 118 kV. Asking in KV, so that's why you are multiplying with 132 kV. So answer will be 118, not 118,000. This is 118 answer. Now it's 26th question. 26th question. So he has given a travelling wave having 400 by 1 by 50 means. 50 means. Is 400 means it is travelling wave having a surge voltage of 400 kV, which is travels. Surge voltage of 400 kV travels with a rise time of 1 means 1 microsecond. 1 microsecond and fall time of surge will be 50 microsecond. Why it is only microseconds? Why? Because the velocity of light is what? 3 into 10 to the power of 8 or 300 meters per microsecond. So the velocity of light will be equal to what? 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second, or 300 meters per microsecond. So always we are measuring the signal, the time of the signal at which it is falling is in terms of microseconds. So it is time should be mentioned, both rise time and fall time should be mentioned in microseconds. Okay. So but voltage of surge voltage will be in terms of kV, it is 400 kV. It's a 400 kV line with the rise time of 1 microsecond and having fall time of 50 microsecond. So be remember, the time should never be in seconds. Why? Because signal which is traveling with a velocity of 300 meters per microseconds. Okay? That much of fast it is. Next. Now see 18th question. 18th question. Question number 18. So the generator is connected through a 200 MVA generator. This generator is connected through a 20 MVA 13.8 by 138 kV step up transformer. Okay, so it is step up transformer. So it is 13.8 by 138 kV and 20 MVA transformer. Okay, to a transmission line at the receiving end of the line. To a transmission line at the receiving end of the line, a line load is supplied through a step down transformer. This is a transmission line and it is load is supplied through a step down transformer like this. At the receiving end of this is sending end of the line, this is receiving end of the line. Receiving end of the line is supplying a load say it as motor load through a step down transformer of 138 by 69 kV and 10 MVA step down transformer a 0.72 per unit load means load is of having 0.72 per unit of load reactance is evaluated on load side transformer ratings as base values. So this value is evaluated on load side values of step down transformer ratings. Okay, so for the system base values of 10 MVA and 69 kV in the load circuit, the value of the load in per unit in generator circuit is, means in the load circuit he has taken the base values of how much, 10 MVA comma 69 kV. As I already said, if I want to find out the per unit equivalent reactance diagram, since the transformer present in the network, on this side make the two levels, two voltage levels. On this side will base voltage will be base MVA of 20 MVA, 13.8 kV. On this side of this transformer, 138 kV, 20 MVA. So since it is also a transformer, on this side, what are the base values? It is 10 MVA, 69 kV, these two are of these two values only. So he never give the mismatch voltages. Okay, so it is 13.8, 138 kV. It also is what, 138 kV. Then after this one, 69 kV. He never give you mismatch voltages if the transformer is given. Okay, so it is load reactance having, suppose it has motor reactance of 0.72 per unit on base values of 10 MVA and 69 kV. Now we need to find out the value of this new value of per unit reactance of load on generator circuit. Now see, this is generator circuit. What are the base values? Here the base values will be 20 MVA, 13.8 kV. Here I am dividing the line. Here I am dividing the voltage levels and base values like this, this side. So you have to take common base MVA throughout the line. It is 20 MVA you have to take. Okay. It is 20 MVA, 13.8 kV. So find out the new value of this one. So which will be new value of reactance, per unit value of reactance of load is equal to old value into new base MVA of 20 by old base MVA. Old base voltage 69 kV by new base voltage will be 13.8 kV whole square. So if you calculate this one, you are getting 36 per unit of reactance value of load on the generator circuit. This way we are calculating this one. Similarly, you can try to make the per unit equivalent reactance diagram, means impedance diagram, for the 19th question. We can solve the 19th question by your own. Okay? It is just as similar as that of, as I explained in the example in per unit method. Okay? So, in this way we are finding or we are analyzing any fault analysis by using ZBus. We are finding per unit value of any motor or a load on new values. Distribution system also we can solve in any way. Okay? We'll meet in the next class with the next lecture. And thank you. And bye.